The Federal Aviation Administration, or FAA, has issued a notice of proposed special conditions addressing the A321XLR's integral rear center tank, or RCT. According to the regulator, the aircraft will have an unusual design feature compared to the airworthiness standards for commercial aircraft. The A321XLR's rear center tank is positioned aft of the center wing fuel tank and behind the wheel bay, partially replacing the aft cargo compartment of the A321neo. The top of the tank would be directly below the floor of the cabin, while the fuel tank's walls would be part of the aircraft structure. However, the exterior skin would also be part of the walls of the fuel tank, which the FAA pointed out are typically separate boundaries on other fuselage fuel tanks. As part of the documentation, the FAA stated, "The integral RCT is installed in a location that may be exposed to the direct effects of post-crash ground or pool fuel-fed fires." The regulator noted that it considered designs widely used in commercial aircraft, including auxiliary fuel tanks, when creating airworthiness standards. The additional tanks are located in the center wing and within cargo holds, and they are referred to as auxiliary center tanks, or ACTs. The A321XLR will have the integral RCT and optional ACTs, but the FAA is concerned about the RCT's exposure to the direct effects of post-crash ground fire since its walls are part of the external fuselage skin. Furthermore, the unusual configuration will result in the integral RCT not using insulation, usually lining the fuselage of a commercial aircraft. The model A321neo-XLR integral RCT may or may not have equivalent capability of past designs approved with existing regulations due to the RCT design and location being integral with the fuselage. With these concerns, the FAA issued a set of special conditions requiring Airbus to ensure that the lower half of the A321XLR's fuselage, spanning the longitudinal location of the RCT, would be resistant to penetration from an external fuel-fed fire. It added that the intent was for the applicant, Airbus, to show that ignition sources do not occur due to the external heat applied to the integral RCT from an external fire. As such, Airbus would have to prove that the A321XLR has sufficient post-crash fire safety performance of the fuel tank skin or structure to enable passengers and or crew to evacuate safely if an integral RCT is exposed to an external fuel-fed ground fire. Airbus must demonstrate to the FAA that the integral RCT's design prevents fuel vapors from igniting inside the fuel tank for at least 5 minutes. The regulator said that 5 minutes would be consistent with its studies, which showed that the time period would enable passengers and crew members to evacuate the aircraft. The FAA also suggested that Airbus could consider a flammability reduction system or ignition mitigation system to comply with its requirements. How do you think this concern from the FAA will impact the A321XLR's timeline? Let us know by leaving a comment. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.